NMR is an abbreviation for nuclear magnetic resonance. For the analysis of molecular structures at the atomic level, electron microscopy and X-ray diffraction instruments can also be used. But the advantages of NMR are that sample measurements are non-destructive and there is less sample preparation required. NMR spectroscopy is a versatile tool that provides information not only on the structure, but also on dynamics of various biological and synthetic molecules at the atomic level. In the case of liquid NMR, we can perform experiments on samples in liquids that can be, for instance, resemble the cellular environment, allowing biologically relevant states to be observed. In our NMR center, we have at the moment 5 NMR spectrometers of high field that can be used for liquid samples. These are 800, 3600 and 400 MHz NMR spectrometers. The 800 and 2600 MHz NMR instruments, equipped with cryoprobes, offer high resolution and sensitivity that allow for the study of 3D structures and dynamics of complex systems with large molecular masses, like proteins and nucleic acids in solution. One of the 600 and 400 MHz instruments are mainly used for the daily routine work and for screening and preliminary studies. NMR instrument consists of a computer that is used for instrument control and data processing. A spectrometer that transmits and receives the radio frequency waves used to make the NMR measurements, and a superconducting magnet that generates a powerful magnetic field that is tens of thousands of times stronger than the Earth's magnetic field. Samples for NMR measurements are placed within the magnetic field and exposed to radio waves. An NMR instrument allows the molecular structure of a material to be analyzed by observing and measuring the interaction of nuclear spins when placed in a powerful magnetic field. When a nucleus that possesses a magnetic moment is placed in a strong magnetic field, it will begin to process. If the sample placed in this magnetic field is irradiated with radio waves at the same frequency as the precession frequency, an NMR spectrum can be obtained. NMR involves the detection of radio frequency signals from several types of atoms placed in a magnetic field. The specific frequency of each atomic nucleus depends on the interactions with other atoms in the molecule. By measuring the frequencies of hundreds of nuclei within the investigated molecule, its molecular structure can be constructed.
One of the main requirements for liquid NMR is that the sample is soluble in a particular deuterated solvent such as D2O, DMSO, chloroform, methanol, DMF, acetone, or in a combination of different solvents. The molecules investigated in the sample should also contain NMR active nuclei. In principle, NMR can detect signals from any atomic nucleus, since every element in the periodic table has at least one NMR active isotope. However, a low natural abundance of these isotopes can be a problem. The most commonly investigated NMR active nucleus is the hydrogen 1 nucleus, called a proton in NMR. In the case of hydrogen, the natural abundance of hydrogen 1 is almost 100%. In contrast, when recording carbon NMR, the natural abundance of the NMR active nucleus carbon 13 is only 1.1%. Therefore, proton NMR spectra can be acquired in minutes, while carbon NMR spectra take several hours or even more to record. With liquid NMR, you can study a range of molecules, from small organic compounds and up to large macromolecules, including proteins, with the use of one-dimensional, two-dimensional and higher-dimensional NMR experiments. Normally, for studies of large proteins, the proteins should be nitrogen 15 and carbon 13 isotopically labeled, and in some cases, protons should also be replaced by deuterium. NMR samples can be measured at different temperatures. For instance, we can measure spectra below 0 degrees Celsius and even at more than 100 degrees Celsius. NMR has become an indispensable analysis tool in cutting-edge science and technology. NMR application fields include analysis of molecular structure and identification of unknown chemical substances, analysis of mixtures to discern the components of complex mixtures, quantitative analysis, dynamics to study the flexibility of different parts of a molecule, chemical reaction speed, identification of binding sites and molecular interactions, and measurement of diffusion coefficients, from which we can determine the size of the molecule.
What we can learn from NMR spectra? From chemical shift, we can get information about the composition of atomic groups within the molecule. From spin-spin coupling constant, we can get information about agent atoms. From relaxation time, we can get information on molecular dynamics. From signal intensity, we can get quantitative information, for instance, atomic ratios within a molecule that can be helpful in determining the molecular structure, and the proportions of different compounds in the mixture. What is the typical volume and concentration of samples for NMR study? For NMR study in liquids, we usually use normal 5 mm NMR tubes, where we put 500 to 600 microliters of dissolved samples. For small organic molecules, we usually dissolve few milligrams of solid sample. We have also so-called Shigemi tubes, where we can put approximately 300 microliters of the sample. The usual concentration of sample containing, for instance, proteins or DNA, RNA molecules is between 0.1 and 1 millimolar. You can access to our NMR techniques via CERIC call for proposals.